Hey, I'm Jocelyn, and today I have a friend who is in desperate need of a night off, so I am going to cook her family dinner. And this is one of my easy go-to kind of things, whether you're cooking for a crowd or you have a big family or you've got a friend who just really needs somebody to take something off her plate. So I'm going to make enchilada casserole. Enchiladas are great anytime, but they are labor intensive. There's a lot of time taken when you're making enchiladas. So we're gonna do this quick and dirty, if you will. And I sent Mark to the grocery store. So I've got like all the Americanized possible stuff you can ask for. Maybe not what I would pick for ingredients, but you know what? It's fine, it'll work. So let's get started. So we'll start with browning our meat, and actually I'm going to cook a little bit of onion. I like to use shallots simply because I find that when I use onions, they go bad before I get them entirely used sometimes. So I'm gonna just go ahead, chop up a shallot really rough, and I'm gonna throw that in the pan along with my ground beef. So an easy way to cut shallots or onions, if you're using onions, just take this flat side down and put a whole bunch of slits in the top and sides like that. Kind of follow the grains that nature has already put in there, and you can just chop and it will come out mostly minced or diced, however you need it. So this is gonna go right into our pan over here, along with our ground beef. I've got this great carbon steel pan that Mark got me for Christmas this year, and it's kind of like cast iron. It gets seasoned and everything, but it's so wonderful and it cooks great. So we'll just throw this in here and we'll let those sweat a little bit and then throw in my beef. Okay, I should tell you, I'm gonna make a double batch today just because I'm gonna make some for my family too, because everybody likes this. And while this is cooking, I am preheating my oven to 350 degrees. Okay, so while my beef is browning, I am going to chop up a lime, and this is just for serving, and I'm just gonna stick this in a little container and take it along with me. So I'm just gonna put a few chunks in there. And then we're gonna chop up some cilantro. I've got an entire bunch. I am a huge fan of cilantro. I could eat it plain. It's really good. So I'm just gonna go ahead and cut off this big bunch, and I'm gonna use about 3/4 of that in the recipe, and then this other little bunch I'm just gonna keep for a decoration on top. So we'll just chop this up real quick, and that'll be ready to go in a little bit. So while this is cooking, I'm going to throw a little bit of taco seasoning in it. Mark picked up al pastor, which is great. I actually like that better than regular taco mix. So this will work. You know, truly, I'm kind of cheating. I usually would just make my own taco spice mix, but you know what? This is what we got, so we're gonna do it. So I'm gonna do about 2-ish tablespoons full. You could add some salt at this point too, but I try to just go with the salt that's already in this because these kinds of things are always kind of loaded with sodium, so I'm just gonna leave it the way it is. So this is just about all nice and browned. I'm kind of letting some of that liquid kind of cook off from the onions. There's a little bit of fat in this, although Mark got a good low-fat beef, so I'm not even gonna deal with draining it all. I'm just gonna kind of let it be. It's not a ton, and you know what? Fat adds flavor, and I like natural fat. I'm a big fan, so I'm just gonna put in one can of red enchilada sauce. You know what? You could do green. I like green with chicken and red with beef, but it's completely up to you. And we'll just stir this in, and I'm gonna let this cook on like a medium, high, medium heat, and just let it cook down until it's nice and thick. I'm also going to add, this is 16 ounces, so this is 2 cups of salsa. I'm going to put about a cup in. Think about half a cup or so per pound of meat would be just about perfect. So as that's cooking down, I'm going to go ahead and get my tortillas ready and start putting them in my pan. I'm just going to cut these into like probably about four little strips each. And it's great because you can cut several of them all at the same time. So I just make a stack and cut through them and line my pan. And then we're going to layer all of these things together. We're going to layer the meat and the cheese, and we're going to layer some cilantro in there. And then we're going to put more tortillas and more meat and more cilantro and all of that good stuff and just build up a nice little pan full. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and start layering my pan, and I'm just going to put these all in. I do the flat side against the flat side of the pan. And you can overlap. That's absolutely fine. Don't worry about how it goes in. Just cover your pan. Okay, so my meat is completely cooked and my sauce is all in there. It looks really good. And I'm just going to put this in here. This is where this gets a little bit messy. And so I kind of use 2 serving spoons. It just makes it a little easier to get all of this in here nice and neat. So got the meat in, and we're just going to put a little bit of cheese all over that layer. And then some cilantro over top. And then we're going to layer some more of this. And in it goes. Part of why this is a really great recipe to give people is that it reheats really well. You can also freeze this and reheat it in the oven on your own. Just kind of let it defrost a little bit and it should be good. So that's it. We've got our second layer of tortillas and meat on there, and I've got a little cilantro. And then I love cheese. I'm going to kind of douse this one in cheese on this top layer. And then we're gonna pop this into the oven at 350 for about 30 minutes. And when it comes up, it'll be all nice and bubbly. And then we're just gonna put a lid on it. I'm gonna take it over to my girlfriend's house and hopefully brighten up her day a little bit. Okay, so earlier I said 30 minutes, and it's not 30 minutes. It's like maybe 10 or 15 minutes. It's just enough to get everything to melt together. Also, if you're giving this to somebody, it's a good idea to maybe underbake it just a little bit so when you get it to them, they can reheat it without drying it out, because enchiladas should be good and juicy, and we don't want to ruin all of that. All right, so that looks lovely. So I'm just going to throw a little bit of fresh cilantro just right there on top, and I'm gonna give them some sour cream and limes to squeeze on top. You can have some sliced jalapenos, you could have some onions, some tomatoes, like all sorts of good toppings to go on top of this, extra cheese maybe. It's kind of smorgasbord of whatever you want to put on it. But anyway, this is an enchilada bake, and it is a really easy, great thing to do in a quick amount of time. See you later.